funeral homes are coping with more overcrowding. Let's take a look at how workers are grappling with the surge. One funeral home worker appealed to the public on Chinese social media, asking for understanding about the difficult situation.
It's the same for both the head of the funeral home and us employees. We keep working even when we get infected with the virus for days and have a fever or other symptoms. It has to be like this. Otherwise, how can the funeral home operate?
He added that his wife developed a fever multiple times and that his own eyes and ears became painful.
We're working around the clock. During the cold winter, in the early morning, we still have to work. I watched a video last night. The driver of an ambulance had a 100-degree fever. The doctor, too, and a nurse. They picked up a patient with a high fever of 104 degrees.
He sobbed while speaking about the situation. On the outskirts of Beijing, residents report being forced to use excavators to dig graves. That's to manage the high number of deaths locally. And in Shenyang City, a cremation furnace broke down last week. A worker was seen fixing it. Last month, all three of another facility's cremation furnaces were broken. The funeral home issued a notice saying they broke due to, quote, recent continuous operation.